A man is in critical condition following an altercation with a neighbor that ended in a shooting. There's no information regarding the suspect at this time. The shooting is still under investigation. In Lafayette, Jasmine Evans, KLFY News 10.
Transitioning from the classroom to the workforce is always a bumpy road, but when opportunity knocks, you open the door because experience has no substitute. Last Friday, you all had their traditional Rock the Swamp ceremony. The event consists of students, graduation rings being placed in the school's on-campus swamp.
Rock the Swamp is a UL Lafayette tradition and is sponsored by the university's alumni association. The event is held here at Cypress Lake and is one that sets this university apart from many.
As the temperatures rise, it is important to remember to never leave your pets in the car. Our Brianna Tebbs has more.
This holiday season, over 50,000 people will gather here at Acadian Village to tour over 500,000 Christmas lights. All proceeds made this holiday season at Acadian Village will go towards LARC. Jasmine Evans, KLFY News 10.
New safety concerns regarding ride-sharing apps are on the rise. Danielle Johnson shares some tips on how to protect yourself when getting into an Uber or a Lyft.
As thousands of hungry customers pull into their local drive-thrus, one thing remains on their mind: getting their hands on this Popeye's chicken sandwich. Because such high demand for the chicken sandwich, the company plans to hire over 400 new employees to handle the rush next month upon the chicken sandwich arrival. For KLFY News 10, I'm Jasmine Evans.
A local soccer team recently started up here in Lafayette, and they're unique in more ways than one. They are known as the Louisiana Crew. Our Logan Ottervane has the story.
Tonight, the ladies are bringing a little something extra to the streets of Lafayette and the crew of Carnival in a Rio parade. The parade is expected to have over 100,000 spectators.
And finally, I'm sure by now most of you have heard about the tragedy of the Notre Dame Cathedral fire. Our reporter Taz Thomas has more on the influence it had right here in Louisiana.